From Nashville, Tennessee, the country music capital of the world and home of the Air Castle of the South, it's time for the Marty Stuart Show, featuring Marty Stuart, the Rolls Royce of country singers, Miss Connie Smith, the old Tennessee slicker, Leroy Troy, along with all the fabulous superlatives, Cousin Kitty Bob, Handsome Harry Stinson, the Apostle Paul Martin, Gary Carter on the steel guitar, and today's special guest, a member of the Country Music Hall of Fame, legendary Merle Haggard, along with his fiddle player, Scott Jones. Join us now for 30 minutes of fun and great country music. I'm Eddie Stubbs. Now, how about a superlative welcome for our host, Mississippi's master of treble and twang? Here is Marty Stuart.
Back door open. There just had to be an exit for the running kind. Within me there's a prison surrounding me alone, as real as any dungeon with a wall of stone. I know running's not the answer, but running's been my nature, and a part of me that keeps me moving on. I was born the running kind, leaving always on my mind, and home was never home to me at any time. Every front door found me hoping that I would find the back door open. There just had to be an exit for the running kind. Every front door found me hoping that I would find the back door open. There just had to be an exit for the running kind. There just had to be an exit for the running kind.
Somebody say howdy to me. Howdy back to you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. If you're just joining us, I'm Marty Stuart, and you're watching The Marty Stuart Show, and we're glad to have you with us tonight. Superlatives, how about this? One of my best friends in the world, he happens to be the poet of the common man, a member of the Country Music Hall of Fame. How about a hand for Mr. Merle Haggard, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
Love's always lovely when first two lovers meet, hand in hand arm in arm, walking down the street. Always seen together in everything they do. Love's always pretty when it's new. Love's always special, especially to the heart, when it's love on sight and all is right and there's no doubt from the start. Before it starts to crumble, there'll be many shades of blue. But love's always pretty when it's new. Love's always pretty when it's new. Oh, there's nothing bad about it till your lover says we're through. And oh, love's even sweeter, that old saying's really true. Love's always pretty when it's new. Love's always pretty when it's new. Oh, there's nothing bad about it till your lover said we're through. And oh, love's even sweeter, that old saying's really true. Love's always pretty when it's new.
That's the way to do that one. Mr. Haggard, ladies and gentlemen.
Fine job there, Merle Haggard, and the song that he wrote called Pretty When It's New for that album, I Am What I Am. And love that twin guitar work there from Merle Haggard and Cousin Kenny. Y'all are sounding fine.
Welcome back to the Marty Stuart Show, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. Superlatives, look over here. Look over here. Yes, yes, yes. Icons on the hay bales. How about a hand for Miss Connie Smith, everybody? Yeah.
You always find a way to hurt my pride. If I'm not crying, you're not satisfied. I don't know why you want to hurt me so. If you're trying to break my heart, you don't have very far to go. You don't have very far to go before the heartaches begin. I already feel the sadness of a heartbreak sitting in. You're turning down the flame of love too low. If you're trying to break my heart, you don't have very far to go. Don't have very far to go before the heartaches begin. I already feel the sadness of a heartbreak sitting in. You can't love me and still want to hurt me so. If you're trying to break you don't have very far to go. If you're trying to break my heart, you don't have very far to go.
Mr. Haggard, you got a feather. How about a hand for Mr. Haggard, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah.
People don't know this, but he's like a dang mockingbird. He can listen to somebody talk or sing for 20 seconds, and he's got them. I want you to do me a favor. I heard you impersonate Bob Wills. I want you to have Bob Wills introduce Mr. Lefty Frizzell to sing the first line of Always Late. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the king of Western Swing, Mr. Bob Wills. Bob, take it away.
Well, thank you very much. It's nice to be here this afternoon.
Yes, yes.
I'd like to ask Lefty Frizzell to come over here and do us a song. Hot, yes.
Yes, yes.
Always late with your kisses.
I told you, mockingbird.
Oh.
You and me have had a lot of deep conversations about country music, and I think we both agree that the man they call the father of country music is rightly so deserving in that title, don't you think?
Mr. Oh, Jimmy Rogers, you absolutely.
Bet.
Yes,
you bet.
You know, he had a song that was about his life, I think, more than anything else that he wrote was TB Blues.
Oh, man, about the best.
My good gal's trying to make a fool out of me.
Hey.
Lord, my gal's trying to make a fool out of me. Trying to make me believe I ain't got that old TB. I've been raining like a lion. Looks like I'm going to lose. Lord, fight like a lion. Looks like I'm going to lose. God, there ain't nobody ever whipped the TB blues. I've got the D&B blues. But the graveyard is a lonesome place.
Sure enough there, boy, sure enough.
Lord, that old graveyard is a lonesome place. They put you on your back and let that mud down in your face.
Take one on your guitar, hey.
Great job there, fellas. The TB Blues. That just goes to show you that simplicity always sells.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Marty Stuart. This, of course, is Mr. Merle Haggard. Mr. Haggard, thanks again for coming by.
Oh, my pleasure.
You betcha. Hey, you know what? When I go to Meridian, Mississippi, you know what I love to do? I love to go to the Jimmy Rogers Museum.
Oh, you have to go down there if you're in that area. You got to go by and see his guitar.
And see that train. And the main thing is hear some of that music they play.
That's right.
All day, all night, as long as it's open at the museum to hear Jimmy Rogers music. It'll make you feel better along life's way, won't it?
It will.
Hey, hey. Yes, sir. Speaking of feeling better along life's way, I got you covered, Hag.
What's
I got
that?
You covered. Well, here he comes, the Sultan of Goodlettsville, the most popular man in country music, the old Tennessee Slicker, gonna sing a Merle Haggard song. It's big, ladies and gentlemen, Leroy Troy. Hag, he's gonna hit. Yeah, you know Merle, Scott. Connie. There he is, Hag, in person, right there. That's the fellow that wrote this song.
Yeah, I know it.
I come by your house last night, window was up, and you were singing Merle Haggard songs. How about you?
I was.
Well, all right.
Yeah, got mighty warm, it did.
It did.
Well, you're going to help me sing, okay?
All right.
And I got a handsome Harry.
We'll try.
Lonesome Harry. Tonight, we're going to do a song called The Old Man from the Mountain.
A good one.
Yeah. Well, the old man from the mountain's coming home. Thought I'd better warn you, so I called you on the phone. Get rid of Joe the grinder, you better be there alone. Cause the old man from the mountain's coming home.
Yeah.
I've been working in a sawmill. I'm all uptight and tense. I got wind that someone's been a-digging under my back fence. I thought I'd better call you, let you know today that the old man from the mountain's on his way. Get rid of Joe the grinder, you better be there alone, cause the old man from the mountain's coming home. Bunch of good loving, so I'm a coming down the hill. Don't want no friend of Henry's a warming up my bed. And the old man from the mountain means what he says. Yeah, the old man from the mountain's coming home. Thought I'd better warn you, so I called you on the phone. Get rid of Joe the grinder, you better be there alone, cause the old man from the mountain's coming home. Yeah, the old man.
Fine job there from Leroy Troy and the old man from the mountains. I think Merle Haggard had Leroy Troy in mind when he wrote that song years ago. That's fine. Well, you know, we'd like to declare hymn time this week, and Sunday morning's going to be around before you know it, and we do hope that you and yours will make the time to attend the church of your choice. To get us in the mood, we're going to call on Connie Smith to sing a song that Merle Haggard wrote years ago that speaks to the times, Jesus, Take a Hold.
Like the ancient Roman Empire, this world is doomed to fall. And it's much too big a thing for mortal man. Just take a look around and see the writing on the wall. Somehow we've got to find a helping hand. This world has never been people scorn the things our leaders do. It's time a prayer was spoken from the heart of every man. Jesus, take a hold and lead us through the mighty roar of gunfire is now a local sound. Our city streets are filled with angry men. Law is now a mockery throughout our troubled land. And destruction seems to be the current trend. This world has never been in the awful shape it's in. Our leaders seem in doubt of what to do. It's time a prayer was spoken from the heart of every man. Oh, Jesus, take a hold and lead us through. Jesus, take a hold and lead us through.
And now with more treble and twang, here again is Marty Stuart.
Thank you, Mr. Stubbs. And how about a hand one more time for the poet of the common man, Mr. Merle Haggard, everybody. On behalf of all the superlatives, much love to Merle Haggard and all the strangers. Hey, one little piece of business to take care of. Right behind you where Miss Beth is standing, we have a permanent piece that's going to go on our set from this day forward, if that's all right with you. How about it, Beth? I like that. Well, since that's up there, why don't we just play the dang national anthem? What do you think?
Working Man Blues?
That's the one, all right.
It's a big job getting by with 9 kids and a wife. Yeah, but I've been a working man dang near all my life, and I'll keep on working long as my two hands are fit to use. Drink a little beer at a tavern and then cry a little bit of them working man blues. Well, I keep my nose on the grindstone, work hard every day, get tired on the weekend. After I draw my pay, but I go back working. Monday morning, I'm right back with the crew. Drink a little beer at a tavern and then try a little bit of them working man blues. Bumming around when my bill's at the window, catch a train to another town. We'll go back working. Got to buy my kids a brand new pair of shoes. Drink a little beer at a tavern and then cry a little bit of them working man. All right, work on it, Marty. Working man like me, never been on welfare, and that one place him will not be. Him will be working long as his two hands are fit to use. Drink a little beer at a tavern and then try a little bit of these working man blues. This song goes out especially for all the hardworking fellows here in this evening.
I say yeah, I say yeah. On behalf of Merle Haggard, Scott Shaw, Connie Smith, the fabulous Ameripolitan, Leroy Troy, Eddie Stubbs, Gary Carter, I'm Marty Stuart saying thank you for coming to see us. We'll see you again next week right here on the Marty Stuart Show. Thank you, Haggard.